Hi again. In this section, we are going to see how we can implement the fault analysis in power system. We are going to see the effect of different types of faults, symmetrical and unsymmetrical faults on a simple power system. So first of all, let's see our example to be implemented. If we have here a generator, this generator has a rating power 10 megavolt ampere. And the voltage is 11 kilovolt and frequency is 50 hertz. This generator is connected to a transformer connected delta star and has a rating power 10 megavolt ampere and turns ratio is 11 to 0.4 kilovolt. And also have here a load. This load is consuming 5 megawatt and also 20 kilovar at a voltage 0.4 kilovolt. And if here a three-phase fault occurs at the load. Now, we are going to see the effect of this type of fault. If this fault is symmetrical or unsymmetrical, the effect of this type of fault on the voltage and also the current. So now, let's go to our MATLAB Simulink to first represent our generator. How we can represent our generator? Let's go to the library browser and search for our power library, as we can see. And go to electrical sources and select here three phase source. Add to our model, our three phase source. And also in order to simulate the transformer, let's go to elements to select our three phase transformer. Here we can select our three phase transformer. Here we have a three phase transformer to wind. Right click and add to our model. All of these components are simulated in the previous sections and tutorials in the sections of transformers and generators and transmission lines and so on. Now we need to go to measurements to select our three phase VI measurement to measure the voltages and currents of the system. And also don't forget to go to elements again to represent our load, which is three phase RLC load. Three phase RLC load, as you can see, parallel RLC load, and add to our model, and don't forget to select our power GUI. As we can see, here are our components. As we can see, first of all, we have our generator. Let's name it generator, and double click on it to adjust the parameters of our generator. So according to the example, the phase-to-phase RMS voltage is 10 kilovolts. So let's write 10 e to the power 3, which is 11 kilovolt. As we can see, the phase angle is 0. The frequency is 50 hertz. As we can see, internal connection is star to ground. And also here, for calculating the short circuit level, we are going to mark on this icon. And the three-phase short circuit level at base voltage, let's make it 20 megavolt ampere. 20 megavolt ampere, as we can see. And the base voltage is 11 kilovolt. 11 kilovolt, as we can see. And also here in the load flow, let's select the generator type is swing or slack, as we can see. Then click apply and also OK. Here is our generator, and also here is our transformer. Let's name it our transformer. Transformer. As we can see, double click on it to adjust the parameters of the transformer. So, first of all, let's adjust the configuration for winding one. For the primary winding, is connected as delta, which is D1, as we can see, and for the second winding is star, as we can see. Then let's go to the parameters. Let's apply the parameters in per unit, or represent the parameters in per unit. First of all, we have the nominal power. Here the nominal power is 10 megavolt ampere, so 10 e to the power 6, and the frequency here is 50 hertz. Frequency is 50 hertz, as we can see. For winding number one, the line-to-line voltage is adjusted to 11 kilovolt. Here, 11 kilovolt. As we can see, 11 kilovolt. And let's make R1 and L1 the same as we can see, and for winding 2, the voltage line to line voltage is 0.4 kilovolt as we can see. The magnetizing reactance, resistance, and also the magnetization inductance, let's keep them the same as we can see. Then click apply and also OK. So here is our transformer. Connect the generator to our transformer as shown here. Then we have here our three phase VI measurement. As we can see, our three phase VI measurement. Double click on it. The voltage measurement is phase to ground, as we can see. Then click OK. After that, we have here our load. Let's rotate it and let's name it our load, as we can see. Our load, as we can see. Let's double click on it to adjust its parameters. For our load, we have the nominal phase to phase voltage is 0.4 kilovolt. The nominal frequency is 50 hertz. The active power is 5 megawatt, as you can see, 5e to the power 6. And the inductive reactive power is 20 kilovar, as we can see, so 20e to the power 3. And the capacitive power is 0. Capacitive power is 0, as we can see. And the load also is connected as star. Click apply and also OK. So here is our load. Let's connect our load to the output of the three phase VI measurement. Here, the three phase VI measurements is acting as a voltmeter and also a meter to measure the voltages and the current of our system as shown here. Now, in order to see the voltages and also the current, so let's use a scope. Let's search for a scope and double click to select our scope. But here, for this terminal, in this terminal, we can see the three phase voltages in one port. So in order to separate the three phase voltages, to see them separately, so we need a demultiplexer. So let's search for a D-MUX. As we can see, double click on the multiplexer, double click and select the number of outputs are 3. So let's connect this multiplexer to VABC, as we can see here. And let's double click on the scope. Click here at the setting icon and select the number of axis 3 and go to history to disable this icon, which is limit data points to last, as you can see. Then apply and also OK. So we have here our D-MUX. Let's zoom it in, as you can see, and also the scope. And let's name this scope is our voltages. Our voltages, as we can see, connect here as shown. Let's do the same thing for the currents. Let's use another multiplexer. As you can see, Control C and Control V. And also, let's use another scope as shown. Let's name it our currents. And connect IABC to this terminal as shown. Now it's time to represent our three phase fault. How we can represent our three phase fault as shown? So we can go to the library browser and go to elements. As we can see, we can find our three phase fault here, our three phase fault. So let's select this three phase fault and connect the three terminals A to A here, and also B to B, and here C to C. So this is a representation of the three phase fault in our system as shown. Double click on the three phase fault. We can see, first of all, the initial status is 0. Here, the fault, we can fault between, we can determine the type of fault here. Phase A, phase B, phase C, and ground. So the type of fault now is three phase to ground. Here is a switching time. We can use the external feature, as you can see, in order to adjust the time that the fault will occur in the power system. and also here the fault resistance will be very small, and also the ground resistance, snubber resistance is a high value, and snubber capacitance is infinity. So let's keep all of these parameters the same, but use the external feature. As we can see, if we use the external feature and click apply, so another port will appear, or another terminal will appear, and this terminal is here. This terminal, in order to connect this terminal, let's use a step function. Double click here on the step function or step input and connect this step input to our three phase fault. Let's double click on step. So what is the meaning of that? So the initial value is zero, so this means that there is no fault at time. Let's make 0.1 second. After 0.1 second, the final value of the step will be 1, so the fault will occur at step time 0.1 second, as we can see, as shown here in our MATLAB Simulink model. Now let's reduce the simulation time to make it 1 second, as we can see, and go to simulation model configuration parameters to see and select the last solver as shown. Now let's run our model. Don't forget that our fault is three phase to ground fault. First of all, let's see this symmetrical type of fault, which is three phase to ground. Run the model. Let's see our currents. So as shown, first of all, we have our three phase balanced currents, as we can see, for phase A and phase B and also phase C. At 0.1 second, a fault occurs, as we can see, so the three phase currents will increase, as we can see. The three phase currents increase, as we can see, because our fault is a three phase to ground fault. But if we double click on the three phase fault, and let's make our fault now unsymmetrical, and its type is phase to ground or line to ground, then click apply and also click OK. Now run the model, see the currents. So what will happen? The first phase, which is phase A, at 0.1 second, the phase current or phase A current will increase, but the other two phases will be the same, because one phase will be connected to the ground. Our fault is line to ground fault. And what about the voltages? Let's see the voltages. As we can see, when a fault occurs, we know that the voltage will decrease. So the voltage of phase A only decreases because our fault is line to ground fault. Let's double click on the three phase fault and make our fault is between phase B and phase C, line to line fault between phase B and phase C. As we can see, click apply and also OK to see the currents. As we can see here, the phase B current and also phase C currents increase at 0.1 second, the time of fault occurring, as we can see. And also we expect that the phase B voltages and phase C voltages will decrease, as we can see. If we go to the step time here, and if we make it 0.3 second, so the fault will occur at 0.3 second. At 0.3 second, as we can see, the time of the fault is shifted, as we can see. So that's all about the fault analysis, symmetrical and unsymmetrical, for a simple power system as shown. In the next tutorials, we are going to see how we can use overcurrent relay, design overcurrent relay, and use it in this power system in order to interrupt the circuit in case of faults. Thank you, and see you in the next tutorials.